fired Tennessee clay. Next big thing. Sometimes I wonder if people get my sense of humor. Actually, I never really wonder that, and I'm pretty sure I assume they don't. Wondering if you're getting used to the idea that you're sitting here watching somebody make mud pie. It's gonna be delicious. Really, what I'm doing is I'm using a fire to remove the moisture from this natural clay that I harvested myself and refined and cleaned all by hand. And now I'm using, like I said, fire to speed up the drying process, all while mixing in some charming little specks of ash now and then, as well as maybe DNA, hair cells or whatever. So it's a lot like scrambled eggs. You just kind of keep going until they're scrambled. Except with scrambled eggs, they get wet. Yeah. Overcook them with this, it gets drier. Now we're moving. Some steam coming off, that's good. Means the moisture's leaving. Stop scrambling so you can see that steam. To scald or burn, like, don't want dry spots because that makes it more difficult to mix in later. So that's why I just put stir in. I just did that so you can see the steam. Burning down the house. No, it's just barely warm. Because I'm constantly mixing it together, so it doesn't get too hot. But I'm gonna let it simmer here in a minute. It might bubble some as the water converts to steam and the steam leaves the mud. more minutes. Hey, remember, you're the guy or girl watching, or whatever you are, watching this random guy making freaking hot clay or whatever in the middle of nowhere. So, who's the weirdo? And I have a purpose here, doing this. What are you doing here? You're watching me. See, all this dry stuff is just going to add to the clay, so it's all clay, whether it's wet or dry at this point, because it'll all just bake right into that clay. Lumps in there from clay drying prematurely, so I want to try and keep the lumps out, although I'll never keep them all out. I keep as many out as I can, but keep it mixed up. Otherwise it dries in evenly, and if that happens, then I've got to, you know, mix the two together, and see, I'm getting that issue right here. Again, it's all clay. All you have to do is scrape it up off the bottom and it remixes into the rest. I dried out earlier. So it's still, there's no temper in there, so it's just pure clay. There's steam coming off, it's getting thicker. That's water leaving the clay. This can be done on a suitably flat rock. The rock will also help to dry the clay out. Again, gotta keep the steam coming off it so that I know that moisture's leaving. See? Takes a few minutes to get up the driveway. She's been home for about 30 seconds now. She'll be up here in about a minute and a half. I'm not worried about the clay drying too quickly. I'm worried about the heat in the clay, because you don't want hot clay on your hand. It's sticky and it's dense. The denser something is, the faster it can transfer that heat to you. Stone muttery. Wait, probably shouldn't do that. They probably get mad. Almost touched that hot butter I just told you about. Get that mix back in there before I go mess with it. Thank you. up, Lemon? Off camera, or maybe on camera, is Lemon. My kitty. Your brother. He's a twin, you know? Where's your twin? Where's your twin brother? Oh, I see him. That's Tangerine over there. You can't see him. He's off camera. I'll show you him in a minute. Oh, I'm not even sure if you can see Lemon. Thank you. of this dust in here is unfired clay that's dried around the edges. So you can see it becomes a powder. This is just the liquid that I use. So using the dust just kind of helps it speed up the drying process. It doesn't affect the characteristics of the clay at all, because this clay will eventually wetten all of those little nodules of clay, and they'll get reabsorbed into the body. However, if I were to be adding bits of clay that had been fired, that's called temper. And we do that to add elasticity, among other reasons, so that we can roll the snake around our finger, see how this one breaks, because I don't have any temper in it. This is pure clay. This is all just my understanding of this process so far. This is my first batch of clay in my entire life. That's really good. So it's got a get kneaded quite a bit, because there's still some nuggets of clay in there that have to be reabsorbed. But it can also just set and do that. And this is at a good wetness for setting. I can put this in a bag or whatever, keep it moist, wrap it in a paper towel, and then I can use it when I'm ready for it. Or I can let it harden, break it up and grind it down, wet it back into clay. Just helps get some of the air bubbles out, if any. Kind of makes it a little bit more dense. Real good. That's about 2 pounds, 3 pounds of clay. Probably 100 pounds left, 50 pounds left at least.